What would happen if the Earth suddenly stopped? You're currently spinning at an incredible speed. From buildings to the atmosphere, from airplanes to you, everything is moving from west to east at about 800 miles per hour. But why? Why do all celestial bodies spin? And more importantly, what would happen if Earth suddenly stopped? This is a question that every sky-curious person should ask at some point. Why do all celestial bodies spin? It's a beautiful, meaningful question because we can easily imagine a universe where everything stands still. But in our universe, there are laws of conservation. For instance, one of the fundamental properties of objects, energy, and mass, which we know thanks to Einstein, must always be conserved. In a closed system where no energy or mass exchange is allowed, whether you mix 50 grams of water with 5 grams of salt or 35 grams of radioactive uranium atoms with 20 grams of neutrons, the resulting mass of whatever molecules form, be it from physical, chemical, or nuclear reactions, must still total exactly 55 grams. Thus, mass, and therefore energy, is always conserved. But conservation laws aren't just about energy and mass. There's also the law of conservation of momentum. This law is often overlooked or forgotten, yet it's vital for understanding how moving objects behave. Momentum is the product of an object's mass and velocity. You can think of momentum as the quantity of motion, or perhaps the grandeur of motion, of an object. The larger the mass and the faster it moves, the more majestic or substantial its motion seems. Take, for example, that 6-mile-wide asteroid that struck Earth and wiped out 75% of all species, including the dinosaurs. What grandeur did it have? Now, compare that to a butterfly gently flapping its wings. There's a difference, right? That difference is described by momentum. In business and politics, you hear phrases like, "Let's not lose momentum." This comes from the same concept. Once something's moving, let's keep it going. Don't stop it. In physics, there are two primary types of momentum: the linear momentum, which results from mass multiplied by velocity, and angular momentum, which arises from rotational motion. Just like mass and energy, momentum must always be conserved according to physical laws. Therefore, if a spinning object collides head-on with a stationary one, after the collision, you'd see the previously stationary object gaining both linear and angular momentum. It would start moving and spinning. Of course, the spinning object would slow down proportionally based on the masses and radii involved. This fundamental knowledge helps us understand why Earth, the Moon, Mars, the Sun, galaxies, black holes, and everything else in the universe don't stop spinning. The universe began with the Big Bang, which was not uniformly perfect. It had irregularities. If it were perfectly uniform, all matter and energy would have spread out evenly, and stars and planets might not have formed. But those imperfections post-Big Bang allowed matter to clump together, forming galaxies, stars, and planets. Another effect of these irregularities was that these clumps had angular momentum. They were spinning. When these spinning parts came together under gravity, momentum was conserved, and the resulting larger bodies also had angular momentum. Hence, everything in the universe spins, with rare exceptions. This spin doesn't have to be in one particular direction. It can be any direction. However, objects formed in close proximity tend to have similar momentum profiles, leading to many bodies spinning in similar directions. In our solar system, all bodies, including the Sun, spin counterclockwise from south to north pole. There are two exceptions, Venus and Uranus. Uranus spins counterclockwise but is tilted 97 degrees, while Venus spins clockwise at 177 degrees. Similarly, all planets orbit the Sun counterclockwise, and remarkably, all 8 planets orbit in nearly the same plane, not at 90-degree angles to each other. This is a common feature of rotating bodies. The gas cloud from which our solar system formed was spinning, which flattened it over time, causing all planets to form in roughly the same plane. We see this in everyday life too. Paint or clay will spread out and flatten when spun. Earth, due to its rotation, is slightly flattened at the poles and bulged at the equator, but not to the extent of becoming a disk. Spin something fast enough, and centrifugal force could overcome the forces holding it together, causing it to fragment. After fragmentation, each piece continues to spin in the same direction as the original. The order from chaos in planetary orbits also means that if planets initially spun in opposite directions, they'd collide, lose speed, and either get captured by the sun's gravity or form a unified spin direction. In space, we see galaxies spinning both ways in roughly equal numbers, indicating randomness in direction. Now, what if Earth suddenly stopped spinning? Momentum would still be conserved, but inertia, or as it was once called, atality, would kick in. This is what Newton described: an object at rest stays at rest, and an object in motion stays in motion unless acted upon by an external force. If Earth stopped, everything not securely fastened would launch eastward at about 800 miles per hour. Buildings would collapse under the immense torque, not just momentum. The atmosphere would keep moving, creating winds of 800 miles per hour or 1,000 miles per hour at the equator. The strongest wind recorded was 254 miles per hour, and winds at 55 miles per hour can uproot trees. Imagine the devastation. These winds would generate shockwaves akin to an atomic bomb, but planet-wide. Water in lakes, seas, and oceans would also shoot eastward, causing tsunamis that would flood coastal areas up to 20 miles inland. Survivors of the initial shock would likely drown. Microorganisms and some small creatures might survive, but life would be drastically altered. Days would last a year, with 6 months of daylight and 6 months of night, leading to extreme temperature differences between sides. On a non-spinning Earth, seasons would be harsher, forcing remaining life to evolve or go extinct. The planet would become more spherical as equatorial bulge forces disappear. This would trigger massive tectonic activity, leading to earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. Over time, oceans would pool at the poles, creating two vast oceans with new land masses emerging at the equator, forming a supercontinent. Atmospheric movements would slow down, ending phenomena like hurricanes due to the absence of the Coriolis effect, changing climate patterns dramatically. Greenlands might turn into deserts, while currently inhospitable places like tundras might become livable. The biggest issue would be the loss of Earth's magnetic field, which protects us from solar and cosmic radiation, leading to lethal radiation exposure for all life, except perhaps deep sea creatures. Eventually, Earth would resemble Mars, losing its atmosphere and oceans to space. If Earth were to slow down rather than stop abruptly, which it is doing due to the moon's tidal locking effect, the change would be so gradual that evolution could adapt. But any sharp, rapid deceleration would unleash the mentioned effects too quickly for adaptation. Thankfully, we don't expect Earth to stop spinning anytime soon. However, a large asteroid hitting at just the right angle and speed could transfer or remove momentum. But since we've never found a planet that doesn't spin at all, there's some hope. Yet, we've only discovered a tiny fraction of exoplanets, so I'm cautious about making generalizations. Remember, even under such extreme conditions as a non-spinning planet, life might still evolve in transition zones between eternal day and eternal night. Earth, left to its own devices, would continue spinning for billions more years. So, there's no need to worry about it stopping. However, our planet won't last that long. In about 4.5 billion years, if we haven't done something about it, the sun will expand and consume Earth. So, relax and enjoy that our Earth will keep spinning for a very long time.